seen very carefully, the area that has been marked with red is showing you the negative profit. And I was telling you that if you are selling, and there are two zeros if you see, which are marked with light blue. So one zero is with the 19,000 units sold and with the price 5.5. And another zero is here where we have the price as 13, but the unit sold is 3,000, right? So what I was trying to tell you that it's actually a choice of an entrepreneur, what he wants to do. As a company which is having the best product, and you know, if you're very sure about the quality, and if you're very sure that even if you increase price, you're going to have the sale in any case, in that case, you may go ahead with this high price. Because that's going to give you this particular, at least break even at 4,000, right? But if you're not sure and you just want to, you know, go for, you know, mass capturing of the market share, you may decrease the price and, you know, by increasing this quantity sold. So as an entrepreneur, I can select any cell from this particular matrix, which is not marked as red, to have the positive profit. Right? And that is the advantage of the data table. All right, so you know, that was all that I wanted to tell you in the data table. And today we have done functions, we have done the goal seek, we have done data table as well. So if you allow me, I would want to do one more, the last option in what is analysis, which was scenario table. So can I do that? It's very simple, just a 1 minute or a 2 minute task. And then you guys can practice all three in one go. And if you have any doubt, we can repeat that one more time just for the better understanding. So I will go ahead with my scenario table. I hope I'm audible and you guys can see the screen also. So let's get going. So going back to this, I select another sheet for the scenario table. And for this, what we can do, okay, so in this case, the advantage is that, you know, just in case, you know, I don't want to work with this heavy sheet and I'm not working with the heavy formulas, I just have a simple table which I want to showcase, and I just want to select the different tables, you know, at the same time, I can do that through scenario tables. So I just write the same thing, just write the budget 2020. And I'm going to write, say, for marketing. So let me just write marketing department over here, and randomly I'm selecting sales, you know, just any variable which I want to have here. So sale, randomly I say 10,000, expenses are say 5,000, and so on. So it's a very simple data which I've selected, but I want to use now scenario tables for the, in this case, I have only one table, but in a similar manner, I may have to make the budget for maybe HR, for production, or for the other departments. So one way of doing that is that, you know, you make these separate tables, you know, separately, and then you can do like that, and you can just write finance here, and let me just correct the spelling. And I can also write these numbers manually and get sorted. But just imagine if I'm working on the multiple tables at the same time, doing that will sound to be quite tedious, right? So what is the option? The option is that we can work on the scenario tables with the help of where we want to work with the multiple tables at the same time. And we also want to work with the different values that we have. So I go back to the data. It's very simple. That's the reason I'm doing it, though we have less time. But let me just do it in 5-10 minutes, and then we'll take attendance. So I go to the data. I go to what if analysis. I go to the scenario table. So as you see from the window, it says no scenario defined as of now. So I want to define the data which I want to work with. So I say at, in the scenario name, the first table which I want to have is for marketing, which is this cell which is already there. And I want to change the cells which I have in the this. I can use this also, and I can have other cells also. So I have this. I already have A1, sorry, B1. It should be B1. It hasn't taken B1. So let me take B1 also. I actually want to work with these data, like marketing 10,000, 5,000, and they maybe another table with the HR department, with the production department, and with the different numeric values. So I defined my scenario table with the heading, first heading as a marketing, and I want to change these cells, and I say okay. So you will have these values in a table that you will see. You can change these values here. Instead of 10,000, if you have 20,000, and instead of 5,000, you can have say 10,000, and you will see the same change. This box will appear, and then this will ask me to show or not. So automatically, as of now, I have only one scenario table, so it is showing me only marketing, right? So I now say show. And when I say show, this will give you the values which I have defined in the scenario table. Am I clear to everybody? I hope the screen is visible to you and you can hear me. Okay. So let's go back to my screen. So earlier I had only one department. So now I want to have multiple departments. So this I'm done with. So I want to do some change here as well. Let me first do the change here, because for this particular table, I want to write department over here, because I don't want this to be taken only as marketing, right? So if you see, let me just change that and let me now work. It has given me, that's okay. I'll go back to that and change it to this. So I go back to now my scenario table. I go scenario manager. I already have this marketing, and now it is asking me to add the other scenario which I want to have. Now, just in case, if I want to have finance, maybe at the same place, I say maybe the same column, they are already there. In this cell, so I don't have to select them again, but since I deleted that, let me select that one more time. So this time I say okay, and it's going to give me the option of changing this, but this you have to do only once. So I can change the options over here. I say 45,000, I say 2,000, let me write 2,000 over here, and 20,000, sorry, and I say okay. And now if it will give me these options which I've already entered in the scenario table. So now I have two options which I've added, marketing and finance. So just now I added for finance, so I want to see that. So I say show, and you will see the change happening on the Excel sheet. Earlier it was finance, marketing, and now it is showing you the finance. Similarly, if I want to see marketing now, I select marketing in the scenario manager and I say show, and this finance will become marketing. So what are we trying to do? We are trying to work with the multiple data at the same place. We don't have to switch over to a separate sheet. It is not going to give me any referencing problem, and it's not going, it doesn't require me to write this data separately over here or in the extra sheet. So that is the advantage of scenario table. In the same place, I can keep on changing these tables, these values, by selecting them and by adding more. In a similar manner, if I go back to the table, I can very easily add more also. So if I go back to what if analysis, I select scenario manager, and now I can just say add more. Let me write for production. I say production, let me correct the spelling. And in this case, for the cell, it is same, so I will not touch that. So I say okay. So production will now, it will not prompt me to enter a data for that. So first time you have to enter the data, but once you've entered the data one time, then later on you can actually change the data if required, as and when there is a situation. So let me change the data over here. Let me just write this. And I write this and this will be done. So if I write this now, you can see there are three scenario tables appearing here, and this box is called as the scenario manager. So now if I want to, you know, it will also prompt me to show if I want to see that or not. So for manager, for production, I say show, and you will see the relevant change happening over here with respect to my selection, which I have made in the scenario manager. Right? So this was a very simple thing which I wanted to do.